Hello everyone, welcome back. And in this episode, we are talking about traveling in Afghanistan. And our guide today is Shamsia. Hello Shamsia, could you please tell us what are the most iconic places in your country?
Hello Amina, thanks for having me again. One of the most iconic place. I haven't been to every city or state in Afghanistan because I was only 9 when we left. When we went back to Afghanistan for a visit, the places that I visited, particularly in my own village, which is called Jaghori. It's in the district of Ghazni. We lived in a valley between the mountains and the rivers flow between the villages. It's so stunning. When I describe it, it sounds like, I don't know what she's talking about, but that's not the Afghanistan that I know. But those were the places that I grew up as a kid. Those were my childhood memories. And to me, not even Burj Khalifa would be compared to that village of mine, because the memories that I created with my friends and the view and just the peacefulness and how friendly people are. There is a sense of belonging. There's a sense of acceptance in there. People know each other. People are kind to each other. The farms, the nature, the fruits, the food, even water. We had spring water coming from between the mountains. In winter, it would be steaming. It would be so hot that you could put your hand and warm your hands in there while the outside is freezing. In summer, it would be as cold as ice, like icy water.
In your opinion, what are the three must-do things for a visitor in Afghanistan?
Have to visit Bamiyan. The two biggest Buddhas in the world are there. One of them got destroyed by the Taliban in 2001. The view from there is absolutely stunning. The hotels are there. It's breathtaking. That's first thing. Second thing I would say is try the food called chainaki in a pot made of clay. They put all the ingredients. They don't chop it or anything. They put all the ingredients and they put a piece of lamb and they seal it so it's not breathable. And they put it onto the hot coal and that cooks slowly. Apparently, it's one of the best food that you can eat in Afghanistan. My final one is go to Mazar-e-Sharif. That's where the most beautiful mosque is located in, with lots of beautiful patterns if you're into art. I would say do all these three things, but you have to visit Afghanistan mountains. They are absolutely breathtaking.
What do you think would shock a visitor in a good way or in a bad way in the country?
I would give you an example of a good shock and a bad shock. The good shock would be the unexpected beauty of Afghanistan, the sights that you don't get to see on media. I say this because I showed pictures of my valley to my friends who are not from Afghanistan and they're like, wow, really? That's Afghanistan? And I'm like, yeah, it's not just rocks and dirt and guns and bombs. The negative shock would be seeing how much Afghanistan has been destroyed by invaders, by the Taliban and the ISIS, how much it suffered the Afghan people and made them homeless. Like in winter, for example, that's when we went to Afghanistan. I was in a comfortable car and I saw little kids at the age of 9 or 8 running around hoping to sell a chewing gum or two just to buy a piece of bread for their family. And these are kids who are supposed to be at school. Afghanistan gets very snowy, very cold. They're running with slippers. Seeing that is absolutely heartbreaking. It questions your humanity. It questions the world.
Thank you so much for your sincere answers. We'll have much more to discuss in our next video.